Hello, welcome back to Funday Chat. I am Wade.
And this is Johnny. Hey, Wade, do you know what happened last night?
Last night, I was sleeping.
Yo, you were sleeping. Yeah. Last night, there was total sound eclipse in the
total
United States.
Total sound eclipse?
Yeah, sun. Oh, sun. Sun eclipse, not sound.
Oh, I think it's called the total solar eclipse.
Oh, solar eclipse, yeah, right. Yeah, solar, yeah, total, yeah. Solar eclipse.
Yeah. But what is a total solar eclipse?
Total solar eclipse happens when the moon moves between the sun and Earth. So that we cannot see the sun directly.
It,
yeah, it covers all of it.
Yeah. Mm. Whoa. So have you ever seen one before?
No, actually, I'm not a big fan of astronomy. And I've heard about it, but, you know, I didn't have a chance to do that.
You're not into all the star signs. Yeah. 什么什么星座。
Exactly. So... But maybe I know that some people, like in the United States, they have, you know, a lot of people, a large number of people, they went out to observe that total solar eclipse.
Yeah. I mean, it's a very, very rare sight to experience. Mm. I personally was not there, but 2017, I was in the States.
I thought you were going to say 20 years ago.
No, 20 years ago, I was a kid.
Okay.
2017, August 21st. I remember this date very clearly because I just recently made a post about it.
Okay.
Because I was remembering the time I experienced the solar eclipse when I was in America.
So you were reminiscing the old time.
Yes. Okay. And it was such an incredible experience.
Well, what happened then?
Let me tell you. So it's absolutely crazy what happens when a solar eclipse takes place. Because what you assume goes on is, just like you explained, you described it. A solar eclipse is when the sun gets blocked out by the moon, and then the Earth, it casts a shadow. And so then the path that it goes on, it's called a path of totality. That's what it's
path
called.
Path of totality.
Path of totality. Okay. So that's basically the path that the moon will take to go past where it blocks out the sun. And so it's usually just one strip. So it doesn't always line up to the entire country, right? Mm-hmm. This year, however, it covered parts of Mexico, USA, and then Canada. And so recently, actually, about, I think, 2 weeks ago, I was doing the news, Funday News, and we did kind of did the news, and we talked about how Niagara Falls in Canada, they gave out a state of emergency because they were going to anticipate, I think, about 1 million people coming to
watch
the eclipse.
So many people there.
Yeah. So imagine if this was America, and if this is the path, then this path would be the path of totality. So anybody else from the other side all will only experience partial eclipse. And a partial eclipse basically would mean like maybe they cover 90% or 80% of the sun, but it's still quite bright. So it's not complete. So you really want to be at the solar eclipse of totality to see like the complete blot.
Okay. So, and you can also see the, what is that called? A corona, when there is a total solar eclipse.
No, corona is the virus that we got.
Oh, not corona.
Yeah. So corona was, oh, you mean the drink?
No. The corona. What is that called?
I'm messing with you. Yeah, the corona is...
called corona, right?
You know there's a beer called corona.
Yeah, okay. So that coronavirus.
Yeah, you know coronavirus.
Some people thought it derives from the beer brand.
Anyway, the corona of the sun is basically the outer part of the sun. Also, dude, are you not wondering what happened to my pinky? I feel like you don't even care. Like, I've just been...
Yeah, actually, I was about to ask you what happened to, you, to your
I'm
pinky.
Like, I've been doing all these motions. You're not even like...
I thought it was a show off or something.
A show off? This is my prop. Okay. This is the path of totality. No.
Yeah,
no.
So what happened to your...
Okay, real
finger?
Quick. Tapo.
Does it have anything to do with the solar eclipse?
It has zero. Okay. Nothing to do with the solar eclipse. But, I mean, maybe people are wondering while I'm using my hands and giving out gestures. Now, what had happened was a few days ago, I was playing basketball, and I went up for a rebound. And when I came down... the person had already grabbed onto the ball. And so I went to try to grab it still. And when I tried to pull away, he grabbed and he pulled it in a different direction. And I already hurt this pinky actually a couple years back, maybe like almost 10 years. Once when I was playing ball again, it bent this way. And as soon as that happened, I bent it back.
Wow.
And I was like,
that was not a pretty sight.
It was not a pretty sight. I was just like, it bent and I was like, whoa, that's not normal. And then I just like flipped it back. And then so the same pinky got hurt again. So uh-huh. I think it was like, you know, an old injury. So
yeah,
I went to the doctors and guess what they did?
that-
All he did was this. Straight up. Uh-huh. No injections, no 麻药, just.
Okay.
And he just like.
Wow.
Oh man,
that's
gross. It is rough, but but yeah. Anyway, it's healing up okay. So, getting back to the corona, it's not the virus, it's not the beer, but it's basically the outer circle of the sun. Mm. And obviously, on a regular day, you cannot stare directly at the sun.
What would happen then?
Like you could go blind.
Yeah, people, you could go blind for
people
that.
People have like you know like hoitzen when people who actually go to watch the solar eclipse without the proper protection.
Yeah, if you know look directly at the sun without proper protection, you would have suffer from some side effects.
Yeah, for sure. And you can't even use if you think like oh I'll just use the sunglasses like you know it can be like 400-600 UV. What is it? UV? Yeah, UV.
Mm-hmm.
That doesn't work actually. The solar eclipse glasses, it's way, way darker. So for anyone who, I mean, it's already passed, so it's too late for you. But for those of you for the next solar eclipse, which I think it's happening in the States in 2046. That's the next one. So in another like 20-ish years.
Uh-huh.
Mm. And that's by that time you'll be like what, 80? 80 years old, I think?
28.
I have to just get an old man joke every time, you know?
Yeah. It feels like it's a perennial.
It's not a personal attack. It's just funny.
It's a perennial joke.
Anyway, it's definitely damaging if you look at it directly, even if it's partially. So only when it's at total solar eclipse can you look at it for that little amount of time. But it goes by super fast. It's crazy because I remember me and my friends.
I heard that the duration for that is only 2 to 4 minutes.
Yeah, this year. This year's was only 4 minutes, 27 seconds. Mm-hmm. But I think when I was watching it in 2017, it lasted maybe about 2 minutes.
Wow. Yeah. Shorter than that.
And it was crazy. Ohio, where I was studying, it was only partial eclipse. Ooh. So we drove 5 hours to get to Kentucky to watch the total solar eclipse.
Mm-hmm.
And three of my friends, we drove over early morning, like 6 a.m. We got to Kentucky, set our stuff up, and then we just chilled. And it's an amazing thing. I don't know if you've ever had any experience like it, but it's like it's daytime because it's like 1, 2 p.m. And then all of a sudden, as the sun is blotting it out, you start to see like the lighting change. So it's like if they had like, you know, started to fidget with the light here and you start seeing like a shadow being cast weird. That was what happened. And we were like so fascinated. Mm. And so when it got to 100 total solar total eclipse, that was like the most amazing thing. Because then I posted on my story, you could hear people cheering. Everyone's like, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I watched that short video and people were thrilled.
It's super crazy because like, all of us are like experiencing this thing together and it's like you've never because it's like something out of a movie, right? Like it's bright and then all of a sudden it gets dark.
Exactly. I think for that kind of like astronomical spectacle, people would, people tend to get very excited when they see that.
And it's innate. I don't think any of us like are like, oh, I'm just going to
be cool. What about you just for one person, watching that? Will it be as excited as that?
I think so, man.
Or that's just crowd effect.
Not maybe there's some part, like, because I remember, like, maybe one person started to be like, yeah, and then another person's like, yeah, and then we're all like, yeah. So I'm sure that plays into it, but it was such a cool experience because it goes by so quick, too. But in the moment, I remember capturing it. I was just like, if you look, you look horizontally, you can see the sunset at 2 p.m. And then if you look directly up, You can actually see the stars around the solar eclipse.
Uh-huh.
And then you hear the crickets like creaking, you hear the dogs barking and like
also the dogs were actually barking at the site.
I know. They're also like, this is amazing. They're like,
like it is said that a total solar eclipse is like the dog eating the sun, right?
Is it?
Yeah, like Legend has it that, yeah. For a lot of like different legends in different countries, they say that for solar eclipse, it feels like dog just ate the sun.
Yeah, like
天狗食.
很多传说.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. But it was such a crazy experience. And honestly, I'm super grateful to have got that experience because I don't remember if Taiwan, if we've ever had a solar eclipse here.
I think so because I heard of this kind of report, you know, every now and then. Mm-hmm. And sometimes partial eclipse, sometimes total eclipse.
Yeah. And I don't know if we're expecting one soon or not. I don't think so.
Maybe not soon enough.
But as far as I know, if you want to experience it, make sure you go to America at some point. I believe, 2046 would be the next one.
2046. Yeah. Okay.
I'll be 50-ish.
Okay. Johnny will be... I lost track of my age.
70? 70 or 60? And still doing the podcast.
I'm still going senile. I'm going senile, as I would say. Going senile.
Yeah. But so like besides the total eclipse that's been happening, there's like been pretty weird phenomenon going around the world, right?
Exactly. Things like some extreme weather patterns that's taken place.
Yeah. You did a reporting on the news.
The other day about the weird strong wind in China. Like suck out three people, you know, out of the apartment.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like that's I've never experienced or imagine.
You know, the wind can suck out the people from the apartment.
I mean, I remember seeing videos and like literally the wind blew and like you had like full windows just like slam into the house.
And the wind
like,
just came out of nowhere.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was like a gust wind. And recently actually in South Africa, we've also experienced some crazy hectic winds in Cape Town, Johannesburg. Mm-hmm. So like freakish weather and like obviously we had all earthquake. And
earthquake these days.
America also had their earthquake.
Oh, for New York.
Yeah.
They are not on the fault line. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So crazy things been going on. Then the eclipse happened.
And especially in Taiwan, I think the aftershocks in Taiwan for like 700 earth aftershocks for 1 to 2 days.
You know what? Like. Up to now.
Yeah, I've never experienced that. Even for
I just don't even know.
921.
Yeah, 921, Joey. Oh. I don't even know now because sometimes, like, I don't know if I'm shaking in my head or if it's
how
like
how old
an
were you when that happened? Like,
Joey.
Yeah, you were not in Taiwan?
Or? I was in Taiwan.
Okay, you were in Taiwan.
We did a whole episode about this, remember?
Right.
Go back and check it out. We did a full episode. I explained my whole story.
What is the name
again? Were you here?
What is the name again? Why are you here?
who are you again? All right, I think that wraps up this episode.
Yeah, okay.
I'm Wade, but what's your name?
I'm Johnny.
Oh, you're Johnny? Okay, cool. All right, we'll see you guys on the next episode.
Okay, bye-bye. See you. Bye-bye.